So in previous class we have studied about acids and bases. So in this class we can study what name of some acids and the substance in which the acids are contained. So, name of some acids and the substance in which the acids are contained. So, acids, substance, acids and the substance. First, acetic acid is contains vinegar means surka vinegar and formic acid. Formic acid is contained in ornithine. ഉറുമ്പിൽ നമുക്ക് അസറ്റിക് ഫോമിക് ആസിഡ് കാണുന്നു. ഓൺസ്റ്റിൻ ആൻഡ് സിട്രിക് ആസിഡ് ഈസ് ഫൗണ്ട് ഇൻ സിട്രസ് ഫ്രൂട്ട്സ്. Citrus fruits. Citrus fruits means orange, grapes, etc. Orange, grapes, lemon. Citric acid. Next is what? Lactic acid. Lactic acid is found in curd or milk. Curd is sour in taste because it contains what acid called lactic acid. Next is oxalic acid is found in oxalic acid in tomato and also spinach means what chira. So lactic acid is in curd and oxalic acid in tomato and spinach means chira. And ascorbic acid is otherwise called vitamin C. Ascorbic acid is found in amla, citrus fruits, that is orange, grapes, lemon, like that. Citrus fruits. So, this is third. Grapes is not citrus fruits means orange, lemon, etc. And next, tartaric acid is found in grapes, undi, grapes, tartaric, grapes and what we are calling unripe mango. So these are some examples of acids and substance. These are some examples of substance and which in which contains what these acids. So these are the examples. acids and substances in which the acids are contained. So next tip we can study about the indicator. In previous class we studied what by tasting we can understand we can recognize which is acid and which is base. If a substance is sour in taste, then it is acid. If substance is bitter in taste, it is base. So we cannot taste every substances. We cannot taste only edible substance can be tasted. We cannot taste every substance. So without tasting, we can also understand which is base and which is acid. Such a substance. So there is a substance, special type of substance, which is used to test whether a substance is acid or base. Such substances are called what? Indicators. Indicators. So every substance. Why these indicators? So indicators. Every substances that we cannot taste. So we cannot identify which is base and which is acid. So in such cases, we can use a special type of substances. These special type of substances are called what is indicators. So what is the definition of indicators? Indicators are special type of substances. Special type of substances. Which are used to test whether a substance is acidic or basic. So indicators are special type of substances which are used to test whether a substance is acidic or basic. So when these indicators are added in a substance, these indicators change their color. Okay, by finding this color, we can understand which is base and which is acid. When these indicators are added in some substance, these indicators change their color. Change the color of indicators by finding the color changed, we can understand which is base and which is acid. Okay. Suppose for example, there are some examples of indicators as turmeric, manyal turmeric, and China rose petals. China rose petals, and we can use what? Turmeric, China rose petals. Litmus. So when turmeric is an indicator, when turmeric is added or litmus solution is added in acid, then this litmus will change the color of the litmus. Litmus will change color. When litmus is added in base, so this litmus will give another color. Okay, so by finding this color, we can understand the substance in which litmus is added is acidic or basic. Okay, suppose the soap solution is added turmeric manure. Soap is added turmeric. This turmeric is changed into yellow color. Turmeric is changed into red. Then we can say that the soap is water basic. Okay, so when acid or base is added into this indicators will change its color, their color. Indicators will change their color. So in this way, by finding the color, we can understand which are base and which are acids. So we can do some water, we can familiarize water. This what is turmeric, how, what is their color change, litmus, and also China rose petal. And also we can do experiments with this indicator. So first we are familiarizing some natural indicators. Okay, indicators are of two types. One is natural indicators, another is mineral or chemical indicators. So first, natural indicators. Natural indicators are the indicators which are obtained from nature. So for example, first example is litmus. Litmus is a natural indicator. It's the name of one indicator, one natural indicator, litmus. Litmus is obtained from the plant, or litmus is extracted from a plant called lichens.